that's a great greeting for Trinity Christian School. You guys are excited to be here. And this morning we have Miss Adeline Anderson as our Bible holder. And if she would come forward at the pledge time, I'll call you in just a minute. But first we're going to recognize our birthdays. So if Miss Beckemeyer can come forward. When I call your name, just come up and stand at the front and you're going to get a pencil and a bookmark from Miss Beckemeyer. All right, starting with Mrs. Banky's class, Adriana Kepke. Happy birthday. And then from Mrs. Volpe's fifth grade class, we have Adeline Bonahenny. Happy birthday, Addie. Then we have Elijah Smith from Mrs. Volpe's fifth grade class. Happy birthday, Elijah. And we have Burke Zilvitis from Mrs. Volpe's class, fifth grade. Lots of parties in that room. And then we have Jawan Jones from Mrs. Tucker's second grade class. Happy birthday, Jawan. From Miss Zakor's fourth grade class, we have Bryn Sargent. Happy birthday, Bryn. From Mrs. Moore's kindergarten class, we have Joey Mirup. Happy birthday, Joey. And from Mr. Baker's sixth grade class, we have Josie Witt. Happy birthday, Josie. And that looks like all the birthdays that we have for this week. So can we sing happy birthday to them? Just a minute, we got to get one more up here. Josie's taking her time in celebration. All right, here we go. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Bless you and keep you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, guys. And now if you would all stand for our pledges, and Miss Addie, if you would make your way up to the center of the stage on the blue X right up here. And we will start with our pledge to the American flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And the Christian flag, I pledge allegiance to the Christian flag and to the Savior for whose kingdom it stands. One Savior, crucified, risen, and coming again, with life and liberty for all. Pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word. I will make it a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I will hide its words in my heart that I might not sin against God. And then our Bible verse for this year is from Colossians 3:23. Let's read it together. Whatever you do, work at it with all your heart as working for the Lord, not for human masters. Colossians 3:23. And if you would be seated, I will pray for us this morning. Dear God, we thank you for this time that we get together as Trinity family to worship, to praise you, and to learn from your word. I pray this morning that you would bless our time together, that we would praise you with loud voices that are singing about you this morning, God. I pray that we would reflect on the words. I pray that you would bless the words from Pastor Brent as he comes to speak to us today, and that you would help us just to have an amazing time together. In Jesus' name, and everyone said, Amen. This morning, Pastor Brent will be coming after Heart Song comes, and they can come on up and get started and get ready. Pastor Brent from Mission Bible Church will be speaking to us this morning, so let's make sure when he comes up that we give him a great, warm TCS welcome. And he is going to be speaking to us this morning about why God calls us to forgive each other, okay? And Heart Song is going to lead us in a few songs.
My heart is yours. You call me out upon the waters, the great unknown, where feet may fail. And there I find you in the mystery, in oceans deep, my faith will stand. Abounds in deepest waters, your sovereign hand will be my guide. Where feet may fail and fear surrounds me, you never failed and you won't start now.
Jesus is Lord, and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For it is with your heart that you believe and are justified, and it is with your mouth that you profess your faith and are saved.
Whoa, I got to do a workout with this. Whoa. Well, it's good to be with you this morning. I'm Pastor Brent, and I'm from Mission Bible Church. And all the Mission Bible kids out there, woo! Yeah. Well, it's great to see you this morning. And we got some of the teachers, Mission Bible teachers out there. Yeah, they're not as loud. They're... Okay, But it's great to be with you today and get to share God's word with you in chapel this morning. I love your series, All In. That's pretty cool because that's what God calls each of us to be, is all in. Not just one foot with Jesus and one foot doing our own thing, but he calls us to jump in and be all in for him. And so today we're going to just continue that, looking at what does Jesus teach us so that we can look like Jesus. I'm sure there's people in your life, you're like, boy, I wish I looked like them. Do you have anybody like that? Yeah, you junior hires do. I know you do. Man, I wish I had their hair. Man, I wish I looked like that. Man, I wish I had muscles like Pastor Brent. I mean, oh, no, I don't. Sorry. But all those kind of things that we wish we would look like and be like. But if there is anything in this world that we should desire to look like, live like, and love like, it's Jesus. Amen? Amen. That's who we should be desiring to look like. So as we start our time together this morning, I'd like you to do this with me. Would you stand again? I know you've kind of been up and down, but I want us to just start this morning with a prayer, and we're going to do a very common prayer. It's a prayer Jesus taught his disciples when they asked him, how should we pray? He says, well, here's how you should pray. All right? So let's say this together this morning. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we also have forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. Amen. You may be seated. Depending on your church background and tradition, some might call that the Lord's Prayer. Others might call it the Our Father. But way too often we stop right there. And that's great. That's a great prayer example. But did Jesus stop talking there? No. Guess what the next verse says? Listen to this. For if you forgive other people when they sin against you, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive others their sins, your Father will not forgive your sins. Way too often in Scripture, we just kind of take little chunks here and there, and that's great. There's great truths in those chunks. But we sometimes forget what is the whole picture that is being taught there. And what Jesus is teaching his disciples is not only how to pray, but how to forgive. And why does he do that? Because forgiveness is a direct piece of the puzzle of how we're able to pray. If we're not good at forgiving, guess what we're not going to be very good at? Praying. And if we're not very good at prayer, we're not going to be very good at forgiving. Those two go hand in hand. There's something about forgiveness that keeps our line of communication with God open. Have you ever had a phone call where there's a lot of static, you know, maybe the person's not near a cell tower or something, and they keep cutting out, and they go, okay, and what do? You go, you call back, because we can't hear each other. Jesus is giving us an insight here that unforgiveness becomes static when we're trying to have a prayer life with God. And I don't know about you, when I talk to God, I want there to be a clear line, don't you? And when God's talking to me, I want there to be a clear line that I am hearing from God. And Jesus makes it very plain. If you forgive other people, just as your heavenly Father's forgiven you, He says, I am going to forgive you. But if you do not, he says, there's going to be static on the line. There's going to be something that comes between you. So today our topic is forgiveness. Forgiveness. If you're going to live like Jesus, look like Jesus, and love like Jesus, you have to be able to forgive like Jesus. There are so many definitions of forgiveness out there. We could take all morning just literally reading the dictionary. Any dictionary readers out there that just love to read the dictionary? Oh, wow. Oh, my. We got some smart cookies here at Trinity this morning. Thank you, guys. I don't like to read the dictionary, okay? I'll look up a word, but I'm not going to sit down and read the dictionary. But forgiveness is one of those things that has so many different sides to it, so many different ways that we can look at what forgiveness is. In the Bible, forgiveness is seen as a willingness to release grudges and reflect the nature of God's mercy and grace in our life. It's something that helps keep us in right relationship with God. But for today, let me just give you this very simple definition of forgiveness, and we'll put that up on the screen there. It's to willfully put aside feelings of resentment towards someone who has wronged you or hurt you in some way so that nothing will hinder your relationship. It's to put aside, willfully make that decision to put aside. Isn't that what Jesus did in our lives? Every one of us sitting here who have asked Jesus for forgiveness, guess what we've received? Forgiveness. And think of our lives, and the longer we live, some of us that are older, I find this more and more as I look in my life, I'm like, oh my goodness, I can't believe all that God has forgiven me for. It's an amazing thing that he took our sin, he took all the harm that we had done to him, and he got our sin out of the way so that there would be a clear line with him. I want to take just the next few moments today and just go through that one verse we read earlier in verse 14 of Matthew chapter 6. And I want to just key in on some of the phrases Jesus uses to help us better understand forgiveness. All right, I don't think there's any of us sitting here, no matter our age, that has forgiveness fully figured out. I know I don't. But Jesus says, for if you forgive other people, if, does that mean you have to do it? No. You got some smart cookies in kindergarten and first grade down here. No, if, just those two letters, just that, how many syllables is if? One. Oh, good. Whew. Two letters, one syllable. You're getting a little English. So you English teachers can take a break today, okay? All right. If you forgive, guess what forgiveness is? Forgiveness is a choice. Forgiveness is a choice. It doesn't just come naturally from us. Every time we forgive someone, we have to make that decision. Jesus says, for if you forgive other people, he says you have to make that mental and heart decision to say, I am going to forgive Cindy for what she said to me. I'm going to forgive John for what he did for me. I have to make that choice to forgive other people when they sin against me. I've often heard the phrase, we're called to forgive and forget. Maybe you've even been told that. Just forgive and forget. It's almost like, okay, say I'm sorry, and then you just put it out of your mind, never think about it again. That's really not what forgiveness is. Forgiveness is knowing what that person has done to you and still loving them. Still getting that resentment and those grudges out of the way, that we will not hold any wrong against anybody. But guess who has to make that choice? You and me. We have to decide to forgive. We have to decide today when somebody maybe steals our pencil. Okay? We've got to decide, am I going to go tackle them and just, or am I going to go, hey, I'd like my pencil back and I forgive you for taking it. We have to decide ourselves. The second part of that verse goes on and says, when they sin against you. When? Jesus is not saying, it's kind of funny, he says, you have the choice to forgive, but you really don't have the choice that people are going to mess with you. Anybody in here have a perfect life where never anybody has ever hurt you? No one's ever said a mean thing. There is not one of us here today that has not been hurt by somebody, no matter what our age is. Jesus says, when they hurt you, when they sin against you. It's not if people will hurt you, but it's when. People will hurt us. I was a first grader. Where are the first graders here this morning? All right, yeah. Great to see you, first graders. When I was in first grade, I sat next to this, our desk, I sat in a desk next to this kid named Mike. And Mike, unfortunately, was a bully. He picked on me. He said mean things to me. And after a while, it got to the point I didn't want to go to school anymore. And so I would tell my mom on school, oh, I'm not feeling good today, or oh, this is, I don't want to go today. Please don't make me go to school. I'd cry. I whined. Some of you maybe that was your thing this morning. I don't want to go to school. I don't want to go to school. Okay? So my parents eventually ended up telling the teacher about what Mike was doing. And they also told me what I needed to do. And did they tell me I needed to go to school and beat Mike up? No. Did they tell me, hey, go steal Mike's lunch next time, that'll show him? No. You know what my parents asked me to do? Forgive him. Forgive him. And it doesn't matter what our age is, it's hard to forgive. And as a first grader, I had to make that decision to forgive Mike. It was hard, but I did. And you know the cool thing that turned out to be? Mike became one of my best friends. He showed up at some of my birthday parties even in elementary school. How did that happen? Did Mike all of a sudden just become this amazing person? Well, he did get some discipline and he did get to have to adjust some things. But you know what happened? I think really it was my heart changed towards Mike. That I was able to forgive him. Way too often, when we hold unforgiveness towards people and we don't forgive them, we think we're going to get at them. It's like our revenge to someone. If I can say I'm not going to forgive them, that's going to hurt them. Guess who unforgiveness hurts the most? Us. When we're unforgiving, we're hurting ourselves the most. People will hurt us. People will harm us. But Jesus says, hey, if you'll forgive other people when they harm you, he gives us this amazing promise, and this is the third thing we'll land on this morning. He says, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. Man, like I said earlier, I look at my life and so many things, not just 10 years ago, but last week, that I've needed the Father's forgiveness on. I'm so grateful that we serve a God who is willing to forgive us. And he doesn't say, I might forgive you. I'll see what I'm feeling like that day. What word does he use there? He says, I will forgive you. And what does that mean? It's a promise. I will forgive you. It's one thing to talk about this thing of forgiveness, but we all know it's a whole other thing to do it. Some of us today are wrestling with classmates today, and I don't mean physically wrestling with, but I mean you're at odds with each other. And they've hurt you. And you're just, I don't know what to do with them. Some of you have family situations at home where you've been hurt terribly. Some of you staff, you have family drama going on in your home. What do? Jesus calls us to forgive. To forgive. And like I said, it's a whole one thing to talk about it. It's another thing to actually do anything about it. But Jesus gave us the most amazing example of what it means to forgive. When he was hanging on the cross and looking down at those who had abused him, they had lied about him, they had beaten him, they had cursed him, they had spit on him. And as Jesus hangs on that cross, what does he say? Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing. When he is in the most incredible pain any human being could experience, physically, emotionally, mentally, every breath is just an incredible, takes all his energy just to grasp to get that last breath. And he's looking down on those who had pounded the nails into his hands. He's looking at those who had lied to him, lied about him. He's looking at those who had abandoned him. He's looking at those who had said all kinds of things against him. And what does he say? Father, forgive them. They don't know what they are doing. When I think about that, it's like, Jesus, help us to forgive us, forgive others like you do. I'm not even close to that, I feel like, many times. God, help me to forgive like that. If we are going to look like Jesus and love like Jesus, we have to learn to forgive like Jesus. And that's tough. But that's the high bar Jesus has set for all of us. And let me tell you today, Trinity students, if you can get this principle into your life, if this comes a habit of your life right now at the early age in which you're living, you have a life ahead of you that will be so much more blessed than a life that if you're starting the habit of holding on to grudges and holding on to anger about everybody and everything. If that's how you're living, you're going to find a very painful life ahead. But if you can have a heart like Jesus, to forgive those around you, you're going to have a freedom to live life truly to the fullest. When I was a sophomore in high school, my family made the decision to move to a totally another part of the state in a totally different town. And my last day at my school that I was at, I was a sophomore in high school, and I was just coming out of the restroom and heading out the door to head home and head out of that life for the rest of my life, in a sense. And guess who's the person that's right there at the doorway when I walk out? Mike. My friend Mike. We'd gotten kind of distant through junior high and high school. We all know how that happens, different things. He was a big-time hockey player. I was a band geek. And so we had kind of gone different directions. But I thought it was so cool how God worked that out, that the last person I saw on my campus that day was Mike. And it was, we just had a quick conversation. I said, hey, yeah. He's like, I hear your family's moving. I'm like, yeah, we are moving down to southern Minnesota. And he's like, hey, man, wish you the best. Have a good life. And that little conversation was only possible because a little Brent in first grade was willing to forgive a kid that was bullying him. Our decisions we make today will affect us long term. And so as this passage reminds us, may each of us make the choice to forgive. Despite getting hurt, because that's just the way life is. We're going to be hurt by others. Don't seek revenge, but instead forgive. And forgive not just to be a nice person. Nice people forgive. Yeah, we'd all agree on that. But instead to truly forgive because Jesus has forgiven you and me so, so, so much. And then that way, we can live like Jesus, look like Jesus, and love like Jesus. Would you bow your heads with me and let me just ask God's help for us to be better at forgiving? Heavenly Father, today I thank you for these students, these teachers and staff, for these family members with us this morning. God, this is a topic we all face and struggle with at times. But I just pray today, God, that you would help each of us to reflect you more and more. Let us look like you more. Let us love like you more. And help us to forgive like you more. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. God bless you guys.